The next question I think is very interesting. So here we go. Why are so many doctors resistant to LDN and why? That's a great question. It is one that I ask often. And this is how, as a compounding pharmacist, someone who I love educating, I love teaching. I take that on as a personal mission. And I love teaching providers about low-dose naltrexone. So first of all, it's not taught in school. It's also not a commercially available product. So there aren't a lot of drug reps out there. You're not going to see commercials about it on TV or in magazines or radio or anything like that. So the information has to come from kind of these quieter channels, usually from a compounding pharmacy, usually from a compounding pharmacist or their marketing team, their education team, or even directly from patients. Low-dose naltrexone has been studied extensively since 1985. There's well over 950 articles, scientific papers, research papers, clinical abstracts, double-blind studies done on low-dose naltrexone. And I really challenge anyone in the medical profession to find another medication that's so well studied, but still not commercially available. It's not commercially available because it's really inexpensive. So, or I should say, it's under the threshold where commercially available or commercial manufacturers really want to study because there are so many nuances with dosing and finding that individual happy dose, it's difficult to say, I'm going to make a 1.5 milligram tablet and the dosing is 1.5 milligrams for a certain period of time, 3 milligrams for a certain period of time, and then 4.5 milligrams. And that's just the way it should be. Well, that works about 50% of the time, or at least in my clinical experience over the last 10 years or so, that hits about 50% of the patients, which means about 50% don't respond. So when physicians hear that, they're like, I don't know if I want to go there. Well, it's an FDA-approved product, but it has to be compounded. So that is where the information needs to come from. And I don't want to put anybody down. And I certainly don't want to put up any roadblocks to hearing a message or to educational pathways. But some providers are really down on what they're not up on. A lot of times when they Google, they just put in naltrexone and then up comes all this. We use this for alcohol overuse syndrome and we use this for methadone withdrawal. But wait a minute. Time out. Low-dose naltrexone is really what we're talking about. And that's where we need to direct our providers to researching the information. But honestly, providers are so busy, it's really difficult to educate them in the 7 minutes that you get to spend with them. So this is what I recommend. This is what I do. This is what our education team does as well. There was an article that was summarized back in 2017 by some physicians at Dartmouth University. And they took the first 900 articles and they summarized by disease state, the mechanisms of those articles, the dosing parameters, and the outcomes. And they summarized it into one paper. And it's pretty lengthy, but it should be. Went over 900 articles. So that's the first piece that I give them. And the reason is because it shows, look, medical provider, we honor what you do. We are here alongside you to help your patients feel better. And a lot of times these are very intense patients who have a lot of need, who have a wide variety of disease states. They tend to be a little more complicated. But we're here to help you be the hero and really impact patients' lives. So this is what we recommend. And by the way, as a compounding pharmacy, we're going to help hold your patient's hand and use very specific questionnaires to then evaluate where they're at now, where they're at in 4 weeks, where they're at in 8 weeks, where they're at in 2 months, 4 months, 6 months, et cetera. And we're gonna take all that burden off of your plate. So we're gonna help you follow your patients, and you're gonna have access to all of this information as well. So that is the message that we go to with a wide variety of providers. So the bottom line is, it's not commercially available. So they're not hearing it in their traditional continuing education programs. They're not seeing it in a wide variety of magazines or online subscriptions. They have to hear it from patients and from compounding pharmacists. So then it's considered maybe a little taboo, maybe a little voodoo, maybe a little off the norm, right? But 50% of all prescriptions written in the United States are written for off-label use. So why not low-dose naltrexone? Why not low-dose naltrexone? It's low dose, it's low risk, low side effect, low expense. Sounds like a winner to me.